Good evening, everyone. How are you doing?
Good evening.
Good evening, Maria Magdalena. Hello, Estela.
Hello, teacher.
Hello, Reinaldo. Hello, Carla.
Hi,
good Hi good Liana.
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening, Hi, teacher. Irma. Good evening, Liana. Good evening, Carla.
Hello. Good evening, teacher.
Good evening.
Good evening, Carl. I'm so glad because you are here on time, always, right? You are always on time, and I like that. Congratulations, and thank you for that. Carla Janet, me dijeron de soporte técnico que debe, Carla Janet, sí. Me dicen de soporte técnico que debe de seguir los pasos para activar la cuenta. Entonces, yo le voy a enviar un video para que siga los pasos, ¿ok? Y pueda activar su plataforma, acceso a la plataforma, ¿ok?
Ok, teacher, yo voy a estar
Okay, Carla. Okay, everyone, we are starting now because, well, in honor of punctuality, so it is 8:01. It's 1 minute past eight. So we are going to start now by taking the attendance. Please remember that the requirement is to turn on your cameras and say present when you hear your name. Okay. Amanda Graciela Perez Orellana.
Alguien me murió.
Okay. Kaleka Bisaí Marinero Asensio.
Present, teacher.
Candelaria de Los Ángeles Nolasco de Flores.
Here, teacher.
Okay.
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening.
Sorry.
Okay. Okay, Amanda. Ah, okay. Thank you. You are the first one on the list. Okay. Kalegi said present. Candelaria de Los Angeles said present. Carolivet Chavez Reyes.
Present.
Thank you. Cristian Edenilson Ayala Ramírez.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Cristian. Delmi Guadalupe Martínez Marroquín. Delmi, are you there? She's usually on time. Edwin Joel Amaya Palacios. Wow. Estela Mabel Orellana de Del Cid.
Present, teacher.
Ileana Carolina Calderón Cisneros.
Present, teacher.
Iris Marina Portillo de Reyes.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Iris Janet Barrera Herrera.
Present, teacher.
Julio César Ramírez Arevalo.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Karen Marisela Rivera de Martínez.
Present, teacher.
Carla Raquel Mendoza Hernández. Kenny Lisette Cuellar de Barrientos.
Present, teacher.
Levin Giovanni Martínez.
Present, teacher.
Oh, okay. There you are. Lizette del Carmen Hernández Mismit.
Present.
Marta Lidia Godínez.
Present, teacher.
Okay. René Armando Avendaño Pineda.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Reinaldo Chávez Guerra.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Let's take care of your audios. Please take care of your audios. Yes, thank you. Alexandra Raquel Ávila de Axume.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Ingrid Yamilet Erazo Aranda. Okay, Carla Raquel. Thank you for saying present. After Ingrid, Jessica del Carmen Vázquez Vázquez.
Present.
Carla Yanet García González.
Present.
María Magdalena Ronquillo Magaña.
Present.
María Luz Yanet Cornejo Erazo.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Vilma Consuelo Guzmán de Girón.
Present.
Okay. Well, this is the video conference number 7, and the topic for tonight is how to use imperatives. This is the new topic for tonight, but first we are having a short feedback. Okay, we are having a short feedback, as always. Okay, let me stop sharing this way. I don't like this way too much. I prefer this other way. Okay. I think it's better like this. Okay, people, look. The topic for tonight, as I was saying, is how to use imperatives. How to use imperatives. Imperatives. Do you have any idea what imperatives are? Do you have any idea what imperatives are?
Imperatives.
Mm-hmm. Like giving orders, okay? Like giving orders. Now, the main purpose of tonight's class will be that you will be able to identify and use imperatives. Identify is a close look of what these imperatives are about, okay? And how we can use these words, because these are words very important when you give instructions, when you give commands, when you are saying some prohibitions. Prohibitions, for example. Okay, so the agenda for tonight is, well, we presented the objective and we are having this feedback about the frequency adverbs first. Then we are going to the breakout rooms to do some exercises, and we are talking about imperatives, and we are doing some exercises using imperatives, and we have to see that imperatives are positive or affirmative and also negative, right? Negative. We have affirmative way of giving orders and negative way of giving orders. So the session one-on-one for tonight is tonight's turn is for René Armando Avendaño Pineda, okay? René, no sé si se va a quedar el día de hoy a hacer consulta, preguntas, después de la clase.
Of course, teacher.
Okay, great, great. I like, that's the attitude. Okay, guys, let's go to the feedback. Let's start this feedback. Now it's your turn, guys. Okay. What does this light say? Can you read what you are seeing on the screen? What do you see on the screen here? What's the topic in this light?
Go to the gym.
Leisure activities, yes. Yes, go to the gym, correct.
Mm-hmm. Play sports.
Play sports. Play sports. sports. Okay, leisure activities. So let's remember about the leisure activities. Do you remember leisure activities that we said the last class? Do you remember? Okay, can you please tell me? I will write them here.
You got to read the beach.
A book.
Okay.
Read a book, go to the beach. Ride a bike.
Okay, ride a bike.
Listen to music.
Excellent. Listen to music. Okay, go shopping. What else?
Go to the park.
Excellent. Go to the park. Go to the park.
Go dance.
Yes, dancing. Good. Dancing or go to dance, right? Go to dance. Okay, great. Go to dance.
Go to the surfing.
Go surfing. Okay. En algunos sí se usa el to y en otros no, ¿ok? En otros no se usa. Por el momento, para no entrar en detalles de reglas porque es un poquito complicadito en este momento, entonces tratemos de recordar, go to dance porque es un verbo, ¿verdad? Go to dance, ¿ok? Si dijéramos go dancing, sería que nos vamos bailando. Pero en go surfing, sí se dice así, ¿ok? Go surfing. Ahí sí decimos así, ¿ok? Ahí sí. Quizás ahorita es go shopping, también se dice así, sin el to. Go to shop, go shopping, ¿ok? Go to surf, yes, it's acceptable, but it's better if you say go surfing, ¿ok? So let's see, go to the beach, read a book, ride a bike, listen to music, go shopping, go to the park, go to dance, go surfing. Do you play sports? Do you play sports, Cara Livet? Do you play sports?
No practico deportes.
Okay, I don't play sports. Okay?
I don't play sports.
I don't play sports. Okay. Well, now let's imagine en este caso que yo ya les pregunté a todos, do you, okay? Y ahora voy a empezar a preguntar la frase que aprendimos en la clase pasada. A ver, acuérdenme cuál era esa frase para preguntar.
How often?
Excellent.
How often?
Okay.
How often?
How often? Y armemos la pregunta. Do you? Ahora usemos una de estas. Vamos a poner go to the gym, okay? How often?
How often go to the gym?
Excellent. How often do you go to the gym? Okay, vamos a hacer esta pregunta, veamos. Ileana, how often do you go to the gym?
I don't not.
Okay, I do not go to the gym.
Go to the gym.
Okay, entonces, como ella... ninguna de las veces, ¿verdad? Va al gimnasio, entonces decimos I never. Okay. I never go to the gym. Excellent. Okay. I never go to the gym. Okay. Now, I'm going to ask this same question. Maybe someone here goes to the gym. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe. Let's see. It is Janet. How often do you go to the gym?
I never.
Okay. Okay. Alexandra, how often did you go to the gym?
I never go to the gym.
Okay, don't worry, don't worry. It's not a problem. Usually we have not enough time, right? So yeah, it's okay. And it's maybe not part of our daily routine, right? Levin, how often do you go to the gym?
Well,
every day. Every day at 4 a.m.
No, no, because I'm fat.
Okay, that's the reason.
The answer is the same with my classmate. I never go to the gym.
Okay, I never go to the gym. Okay, excellent. Thank you very much, Levin. Now, Kalek, how often do you go to the gym?
I never go to the gym.
Okay, good. Now, guys, about another activity we're going to ask. How often do you go to the beach? Okay. Now, how often do you go to the beach? Tell me.
I go to the beach una vez al año.
Once a year. Excellent. Okay, once a year. Great. This is a very good answer. I mean, grammatically correct, and it is correct, once a year. But it's a pity, right? It's a pity that you don't go to the beach so often. Okay, I see someone is raising his hand. Okay, go ahead, please. Oh, it's Levin. Okay, tell me.
Of course. Hey, teacher, I have a question for you.
Okay.
Can I use another frequency app instead of often. For example, how usually do you go to the beach? For example, can I use another frequency app instead of often?
Yes, but it doesn't mean the same thing. Okay, it doesn't mean the same thing. For example, how often is a question phrase that means that you have to explain the frequency or with this activity happened. Okay, so if you ask how usually do you go to the beach, then you are asking specifically for usually. Okay, you are not giving the opportunity, or I mean, in the concept, you are not giving the opportunity to explain. I don't usually.
The question it could be closed.
Closed. Yes.
Closed.
It is closed. Could be like that. Yeah. Digámoslo así para que lo comprenda en este momento. Pero también es. Que estamos como midiendo cuánto de usualmente, ¿ok? Cuánto, o sea, ya es una medición, ya no sería esta pregunta, ¿con qué frecuencia, right? Because how often no significa cuánto de a menudo, sino que significa con qué frecuencia, ¿ok? Ese es el significado de how often, ¿ok?
Okay, thank you, teacher.
Okay, but you can also say how frequently do you go, and it is okay too. But the correct and the common structure to ask for this information is how often.
How often? Yeah. If I ask another way, I'm specifically about the percent.
Yes, we could say the percentage or. Or you are just specifying the frequency that you want to know. For example, usually, rarely, you can use any other, right?
Yeah, I understand that, teacher. Thank you.
Okay, no problem. So let's continue with this, guys. So I'm going to ask, how often do you ride a bike? Let's see, Marielos, how often do you ride a bike? Marielos?
Never.
Uh-huh. Oh, okay. Entonces, estructuremos la oración, Marielos.
I never.
Ajá.
Go to the ride a bike.
Okay, en este caso, ride a bike es la actividad. Entonces, solo decimos, I never ride a bike. Okay? Ah, I okay. never...
Ride and a bike.
Ride a bike.
A bike.
Okay. I never ride a bike. Ahí se nos quedó la pegada, ¿verdad? Ah, bike. Okay, good. Thank you very much. Y así sucesivamente podríamos hacer con todas las actividades que queremos saber con qué frecuencia una persona realiza esas actividades. Okay. Ahora les voy a preguntar una específica, okay? How often do you go to the supermarket? Okay, how often do you go to the supermarket? Now let's see. Karen Maricela, how often do you go to the supermarket?
¿Cómo se dice veces?
Times. Ok, Karen, mire, las veces, acuérdese que si decimos solo una vez, es once. Si decimos dos veces, es twice. Si decimos tres veces, three times. Ok.
Ok. Uh-huh. Entonces sería twice a week. No.
Ajá.
Ay, perdón, ¿cómo veo que se decía a veces?
Times.
Ah. Two times a week. ¿Dos veces a la semana?
Ok. Estructuremos la oración. Vamos a ver. Let's try to structure this, Karen, ok? Acuérdese que cuando contestamos con una oración, ¿verdad? Y la oración se compone de un sujeto, I.
Uh-huh.
Ajá. ¿Cuál era la acción que le preguntaron? Usemos la que está en la pregunta. Go to the supermarket.
Supermarket.
Entonces, la acción, vamos a ver, Karen. I go to the supermarket.
I go to the supermarket.
Twice. A week, right? Usted va dos veces por semana, ¿sí?
Sí.
Dos veces por semana se dice twice a week. Twice a week. Uh-huh. Esta es la manera de decirlo, mire. Twice a week.
Okay. I go to the supermarket twice a week.
Excellent. Excellent. A ver, vamos a ver. Iris Janet, how often do you go to the supermarket?
I go to the supermarket usually.
Okay, in this case, acordémonos de la estructura de cómo es la forma general de usar el adverbio.
I usually.
Exacto. Uh-huh.
usually go to the supermarket.
Ok. Bien, en este caso, tal vez no nos hace falta un poquito ser más, un poquito más específico. Okay, I usually go to the supermarket y me puede decir las veces o me puede decir.
I usually go to supermarket two months.
Twice a month.
Twice a month.
Okay. Twice a month. Okay, good. And this is more specific, right? Usually, miremos cómo está estructurado. Usually va entre el sujeto y el verbo. Remember? Okay. Si quisiéramos hacer un énfasis mayor, podemos utilizar usually al principio. Okay. Usually, I go to the supermarket. Ok, esto es haciendo un énfasis. Ayer veíamos nada más la forma general, ¿verdad? En donde ponemos el sujeto, luego el adverbio de frecuencia, luego el verbo principal, ¿verdad? Pero también podemos hacerlo de esta manera. Usually, I go to the supermarket y ponemos lo demás que querramos poner, ¿verdad? Aquí podemos usar cualquier adverbio de frecuencia. Miren, adverbios de frecuencia hay un montón. Nosotros acá estamos viendo los comunes y son los que más se utilizan, ¿verdad? No, los demás ustedes van a ir con el uso necesitando usar, necesitando esa palabra y la van a ir encontrando de acuerdo a como nosotros hablamos, ¿verdad? A este nivel estamos perfectos con estos, creo que son 8, ¿verdad? Los que hemos visto, 6 a 8.
Teacher,
entonces, ajá.
Can I say I go to the supermarket. I go to the supermarket once monthly.
Yes, you can say that.
In this sentence, I'm using the frequency at the end.
Okay, yes.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. The frequency is the first or at the end. It doesn't matter.
Well, monthly is more a time expression. Okay, monthly is, sí es un adverbio. Sí es un adverbio, pero es más una expresión de tiempo y es específica, es definida. Ok, en cambio, usually, sometimes, no es definido. O sea, podemos decir anytime, right? Sometimes
no
we don't know
veces.
Which time. Ajá. Ajá. No, no sabemos cuáles veces, ¿verdad?
Pero mi pregunta es, teacher, con respecto a eso, que si, por ejemplo, el verbo de preferencia puede ir al principio, en medio o al final.
Exactamente.
Por ejemplo, en este caso, iba al final.
Exactamente, pero eso es por el contexto, ¿verdad? Eso es por el contexto. Y sí, sí lo pueden encontrar así, sí lo pueden usar así. Lo voy a escribir para que lo visualicemos todos, ¿ok? Sería, I go to the supermarket. It was twice. Did you say twice? No, once, right?
Once.
Monthly. Ok.
Monthly.
Y es correcto, sí, claro que sí. Puede ir al final.
Thank you, teacher.
Ok. En este caso, este monthly no quedaría bien poniendo I monthly go to the supermarket once. Es por lo mismo que les digo cuando el orden de las palabras no es como, no casa, ¿verdad? No cae. Sí tiene un significado correcto. Podría estar gramaticalmente correcto, pero en el uso ya no tiene mucho sentido. Vuelvo a dar el ejemplo de negro y blanco, ¿verdad? Ah, tu tele es negro y blanco. Ah, no, es blanco y negro, ¿sí? Estoy diciendo las dos palabras correctas y el concepto es correcto, pero el orden de las palabras le da como el toque, ¿verdad? Entonces, es lo mismo acá. Es lo mismo con este monthly, ¿ok? Bien, let's continue with this. This was just the feedback. So we are continuing with this feedback, okay? Because we have an activity in our manuals. I don't remember exactly the page number here. Okay. And in this activity, we have to write activities. Activities that we do in a regular week, okay? In a regular week. So a regular week means like a routinary week, okay? So let's complete this list with your own activities, okay? And then you have to write the activities next to the word that best describe how often do you do those activities. Okay, entonces, ¿cómo es esto? Acá primero pensamos qué actividades yo hago siempre. ¿Qué actividades hago a menudo? ¿Qué actividades hago algunas veces? ¿Casi nunca? ¿O que nunca hago? ¿Ok? Bien, ahí tenemos esta actividad y nos vamos a ir al breakout room para hacerlo. ¿Ok? Nos vamos a ir al breakout room para hacer esta actividad. Acuérdense del orden en una oración, y siempre una oración comienza con un sujeto, luego en este caso que estamos usando el adverbio de frecuencia, ¿verdad? Y luego el verbo y luego el complemento. El complemento sería la actividad, ¿verdad? La actividad. Bien. Vamos a hacer los grupos. Y nos vamos a tomar 10 minutos para hacer esta actividad, ¿ok? Por favor, ahí ustedes platiquen, discútanlo. La cuestión es que recordemos y que nos quede fijado cómo se usan los adverbios de frecuencia, ¿ok? We're 26. Okay, there you go. Hello, Marielos.
Hello, teacher.
What happened? No se fue al, a la... No se fue al salón, al, al grupo.
Se quedó cargando y no...
Y no pudo. Ok, voy a ver para que pueda practicar con sus compañeros también. Vamos a ver. Bien, Marielos, mire, la voy a enviar. Primero le va a salir un mensaje, no le haga caso, ¿ok? Y le va al segundo mensaje, entonces sí, ¿ok? Permita. A ese no, a ese no.
A la uno.
No, no. No, no,
sala
no.
Sala 1, no.
No, no, no. Okay. No se va a ir a sala 1. Se va a ir a la sala 10, donde estaba. Espérame. Ahorita le va a salir sala 10.
Ok.
Ahí está.
Ok, gracias.
Ok, thank you.
Never... Never,
never,
never I play soccer.
I never.
I never.
No,
yeah.
Never I play. Mm-hmm. I never go to the gym.
Okay, I never go to the volcano.
Okay.
Okay, now.
Yeah. What is the second? Okay. What is the next?
Yeah.
Bye, yo tengo la uno y la dos, pero... No puedo leer. I always listen to music when I go to the work every day. Oh, yes, every day. And I often eat tortas on Friday noon.
Friday noon.
Entendido.
Mm-hmm. Sí.
Ajá. Bye. Esta voy a hacer la otra a usted.
Yo solo he hecho tres.
¿Cuáles son?
I always read a book. Ah, es que tengo que poner la frecuencia, ¿verdad? ¿Cada cuánto?
No, it's okay because hello, how are you doing, girls?
Hello.
Okay, hello. Vilma, you have just to use the frequency adverb given in the table, okay? If it says I always, then you have to say I always go to the gym, for example, right? Mm-hmm. So that's what you have to do.
Okay, thank you. I always read a book enough. And often I go shopping on weekends. And sometimes I listen to music. Pero tengo que poner la frecuencia.
No, it's not necessarily. It's not necessary right now. You can use the frequency adverb that you have in the book. Okay. For example, if it says, I sometimes listen to music, right?
Okay, thank you. Mm-hmm.
I have a question.
Tell me, Lisa.
When I use the verb in this sentence and in this time, is correct use the verb in el verbo en sí, no tengo que cambiar, se me fue la idea.
What verb? O sea,
por ejemplo, cuando yo quiero, sometimes I go to the room. Entonces, siempre tengo que ocupar el verbo room o tengo que cambiarlo running, porque eso ya sería ING, ¿verdad?
Ajá, ese tendría que ser I go running. Ajá.
Entonces,
running sería la actividad. Uh-huh.
Ajá, entonces tienes que ir en ING.
En este caso, sí, la actividad. Uh-huh. Go running.
Bueno,
pero se dice go for a run. Así es como se dice go for a run.
Uh-huh.
A correr, right? Go for a run.
Okay. Y en todos estos que estamos ocupando ahorita, usually, normally, often, tengo que usar el verbo en forma base o tengo que cambiarlo.
En este caso estamos viendo tiempo presente. El tiempo presente es el verbo de la columna 1 en la lista de verbos, ¿verdad? Como del infinitivo, como en la forma base, ¿verdad? Eso es lo que estamos usando. Lo que pasa es que ahí quizás usted se confunde un poquito, será porque hay dos verbos para hacer una acción. Por ejemplo, go running or go to run or go for a run, for example. Pero el verbo principal es go, ¿ok? Es solo un verbo, ¿verdad? Es solo un verbo. Entonces no le cambia en absoluto. Simple y sencillamente usted tiene que ubicarse que el tiempo que estamos usando es el tiempo presente. El presente simple. Entonces solamente es la forma base. For example, I usually go for a run. Okay, I usually go running. Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Thank you, teacher.
Okay. I'm going to another group. Please continue. You are doing a good job. And you are with two, right? Two Vilmas.
Yes.
Okay, no problem. Okay, go ahead.
Thank you. Never. I go surfing. I never surfing. Go to surfing. Vaya.
Hello, Carla. Yeah, I saw your message, but I was trying to see what room were you working. ¿En qué
en el 8 estaba.
Ah, okay. Ahorita la muevo ahí.
Gracias.
Okay.
Ay, disculpe.
No hay problema. Okay. There you go. Okay.
Ajá.
Ajá. Entonces sería primero.
I often es el adverbio.
El adverbio, ajá.
Go to dance.
El adverbio va el verbo y por último el complemento.
El complemento, el replace.
Ajá, entonces sería I often go to dancing.
Ajá,
o to dancing. Go dancing.
Every day. Every three days, perdón.
Excuse me, hello guys, how are you doing? The action or the activity is go to dance. Go to dance.
Dance.
Mm-hmm.
Go to dance.
Yeah, dancing. Dancing.
Dance.
como bailando.
No, sí se puede decir go dancing. Go dancing en alguna, en algún momento y dependiendo del contexto, pero les sale mejor y más fácil ahorita utilizar go to dance. Okay.
Go to dance.
Go to dance. Ajá. Vaya, la siguiente sería.
Bueno, entonces yo pondría sometimes.
Sometimes.
Hello, Amanda.
Hello, teacher.
What happened?
Sorry, estaba en mi trabajo y vengo llegando, entonces hasta ahorita me he ingresado.
Oh, okay, okay, no problem. The thing is that we are in the breakout room, so I'm going to assign you to a group. They are doing an activity on page 20 in your manuals, okay? Page 20.
Okay, teacher.
Okay, I will send you to the group number one, okay?
Okay.
There you go.
Oh, beautiful. Teacher, I have a question.
Tell me, Rene.
Yeah. Why you are so beautiful?
Oh, thank you very much. I heard that someone said beautiful, but we were a lot of beautiful girls here. So, okay, well, I don't know. Just got made me like that.
Oh, like perfect. An angel.
Yeah. Thank perfect. You. Thank you for your words. Thank you. I appreciate that.
You're welcome. It's just really, you know.
Okay.
It's true. It's really true.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay, guys, we have this activity and it's very important when we want to talk about the frequency that an activity happens in your life. Okay, so let's think about a regular week on your lives. Okay, so let's think about Kaleka Bisai. Okay. Kalek, please, can you share the sentences that you wrote using the frequency adverbs, please? Kalek?
No le comprendí todo.
Share your sentences.
Comparte tus oraciones.
Ah, yes. Okay.
Okay. Thank you, Levin.
Ah. Este
metido me dijo.
No, I did not. Hey, come on. Okay, Kalek, come on. Continue. No le haga caso a Levin, usted dígalo, Kalek.
I'm gonna put mute my microphone.
diría las de mi compañera o las mías.
Yours, suyas, yours.
Ah, uh-huh. Ni me acuerdo. Este, por example,
la primera que tenemos, I always
practice soccer.
Okay, you play soccer, you practice soccer. Okay.
Soccer.
I always play soccer.
On Friday.
Okay, excellent. Good. On Friday night. Oh, listen to this. On Friday night. And it's very good that you use two more expressions, like on Friday and at night, and it's good too.
At night.
Yes, okay. And it is good. En este caso, en donde estamos y en el nivel que hemos aprendido, estamos correctos. Él está usando dos diferentes expresiones de tiempo como on Friday, at night, okay? Más adelante vamos a ir viendo que se pueden unir, ¿verdad? Como decir on Friday night, ¿verdad? Pero hasta este momento aprendimos dos diferentes y qué bueno que las una usándolas las dos. On Friday at night. Se vale, ¿ok? Eso se vale. Vamos a ver. Let's continue. Kenny, please share with us your sentences. Kalek solo nos compartió I always. Usted continúe con el siguiente. It was I sometimes, right? Was it?
Sometimes. I sometimes go to the stadium.
Okay, good. And do you go by yourself alone or do you go with family, with friends?
With me, excuse me.
Uh-huh.
With Levi.
Okay, with friends, very good. nice. Okay, you should invite all the group now. Now we know that you go, so we want to go, right? We want to go to the stadium with them, right? I think it will be like
a fun
activity. Okay, thank you very much, Kenny. Now, let's continue with the other activity. It was, often, right? I often. Let me see. I often, okay? Let's see. Can you please help us with that sentence, Delmi? Delmi? Using often.
Sería, I often.
Mm-hmm.
Often. I often go to dance.
Okay, I often go to dance. Ok, perfecto. Hasta este momento estamos hablando en afirmativo, se fijan, ¿verdad? Si lo dijéramos en negativo, ok, si lo dijéramos en una forma negativa, por ejemplo, la que dijo Delmi, I don't often go to dance. ¿Qué es lo que agregamos? Do not, contractado, don't. ¿Dónde va esa don't? Va en el mismo lugar que va el verbo, perdón, lo separamos del verbo.
El adverbio.
Exacto, lo separamos del verbo y lo ponemos antes del adverbio, ¿ok? For example, I don't often, lo separé del verbo, ¿verdad? Go. Si dijéramos, I often don't go, it doesn't sound so good. So we have to separate the no particle, like don't, and often, and go. I don't often go to dance, right? ¿Sí me explico?
Yes.
Okay, very good. Eso no siempre funciona. Hay algunas excepciones, por ejemplo, no excepción, sino que es una otra regla, digamos, para el verbo be. El verbo be funciona de una forma diferente, ¿ok? Yo les voy a enviar un link para que ustedes vean esa parte, porque acá no la vamos a ver así en detalle, solo les comento que para el verbo be es otro rollo, ¿verdad? Es otra cosa diferente, ¿ok? Bien, let's continue with, it was hardly ever, no, I don't remember at this moment. ¿Cuál
never
sigue?
Never ever.
Hardly
sometimes.
Ever?
Sometimes.
No, because Kenny said sometimes.
Hardly no, ever. She says
no, often. Often.
No, often yeah. Said Delmi.
Hardly mm-hmm. Ever.
No, she says always.
Delmi said hardly often, ever. Kenny said said often. Sometimes, and Kalek said always, right?
Okay.
Didn't they? Yeah.
Now
okay.
It's hardly ever.
Hardly
yes,
ever.
Hardly ever. Thank you hardly very much. Ever. Let's listen to Vilma, okay? Vilma, share with us okay. Hardly ever, the activity that you okay. Hardly ever do.
I hardly ever go shopping twice for years.
Okay, I
hardly ever,
hardly ever.
Go shopping twice mm-hmm. For years.
Twice.
Twice.
Uh-huh.
A year.
For year.
Okay, it is twice per twice. Year or twice year. A year, okay? Pero en este caso está bien como si lo así como dijo esa frase, twice per year es como decir semestralmente, okay? Tomemos eso que salió aquí en este momento, okay? Twice mm-hmm. Per year. Es cada seis meses, ¿ok? Twice per uh-huh. Year. No diríamos en este caso twice a year, ¿ok? Si dijéramos una vez cada seis meses, ¿verdad? Sería twice yeah. Per year.
Okay, per si, year.
Yes. Uh-huh. Ahora, yes. Si lo hago en cualquier momento durante el año, las dos veces, por ejemplo, la hago en enero y después la hago hasta diciembre del otro año. No es cada seis meses, ¿verdad? Sino que es twice a year. Veamos la diferencia de esas dos frases, ¿ok? This is time expressions. Twice per year es semestralmente. Twice a year es dos veces en el año y no importa en qué momento la hizo, right? During the year, ¿ok? ¿Sí se comprende?
Teacher.
Yes.
Tell me.
But the sentence, the word, I think is wrong because twice a year. O sea, dos veces un año.
No, es una frase. Por eso decimos expressions. Expression, estas son expressions. Remember, once a day, once a year, twice a year, twice a day. Es una expresión, ¿ok?
Those are time expressions.
Yes, time expression.
Okay.
Correct. Okay. And that's the way to say that. A
Excuse
year,
me, teacher.
No problem. No problem. It's everything okay. And I like questions, guys. I really like questions. So let's go to the next activity because the one, it was never, never, ya la hicimos bastante, ¿verdad? Ya esa la conocemos
never
muy bien.
Ever.
Never, ever, forever and ever. Yeah. Okay, so let's go and let's see. Let's look at this. Let's look at this. Let me share the screen with you because we have another activity that it's very important and we don't want to skip it. Okay, we don't want to skip this activity. Se fue completa la pantalla. Nope, this way. This way is better. Okay, here we go. Look. Take a look in this activity. We had to add more questions to this column. The first column that you have, where you have the numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we had to add some activities to complete those questions. For example, the first one, it says, how often do you have meetings, right? How often do you have meetings? Okay, vamos a agregar entonces. Por acá les he puesto yo algunas actividades. Here you see some activities. And these are activities that usually we want to know how do they say this, okay? Usualmente siempre queremos saber el significado de estas actividades. Entonces se las doy en este momento para que vean cómo se dice. For example, have business lunches, tener almuerzo de negocios, right? Lo que cambiaría sería el tiempo de comida, ¿verdad? Breakfasts or meetings, en todo caso, right? Or meals, meals, para no especificar la hora, ¿verdad? Solo como decir, tenemos comidas de negocios, right? Reunión para comer, hablar de negocios, right? Have business lunches. Use the microwave. We know that in the cafeterias, in our jobs, we have microwaves, right? Do you use the microwave or do you take your lunch, right? Do you take your lunch to your job or do you use the microwave in the cafeteria? Or you buy some, right? Also, that it is prepared, right? So let's see. Leave work late, salir tarde del trabajo, okay? Leave work late. Celebrate employees' birthday parties. Celebrate employees' birthday parties. Esta es una actividad que a todos nos gusta, ¿verdad? Celebrar los cumpleaños de los empleados, right? Fiestas de cumpleaños de los empleados. Go out with your coworkers. Salir con sus compañeros de trabajo, así como dijeron Levin y Kenny, ¿verdad? Que se van al estadio, ¿ok? They go out together. They go out with coworkers, right? So go out with your coworkers. Lo que cambiaría acá sería your, his, my coworkers, ¿ok? Esto sería lo que cambiaría para decir de acuerdo al hablante, ¿verdad? Then have trainings. A ver, de estas actividades que tenemos acá, armemos number two. Let's structure number two. So let's see. Tell me, Delmi.
Have a question.
Tell me.
Go out with your coworkers. ¿Qué significa? No escuché.
Salir con sus compañeros de trabajo. Salir a pasear, right? Salir en irse a bailar, ir a comer, wherever, right? Go to dance, go to have lunch together. Yeah, that's go out with your coworkers. Okay?
Yes.
Ok. Armemos la número dos, chicos. Vamos a ver. Who wants to structure number two?
Use the microwave.
Okay, but you have to structure the question. How
often do you use the microwave?
Okay, good. Okay, so number three. Number three.
How often do you leave work late?
Okay. Mm-hmm. Alexandra, number four.
How often do you have business lunch?
Okay. Mm-hmm. Number five, Ileana.
How often do you go have training?
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. It was go out, go out, o era have trainings. Estas son dos separadas, Ileana.
How train, la two.
Okay. Okay, have trainings. Esa nos faltó explicar, ¿verdad? Pero se entiende. Muy bien. Excellent. Have trainings. Carla Janet, number six.
Go out with your co-workers.
Okay, ármeme toda la pregunta.
Ah, okay. How often did you go out with your co-workers?
Okay. Oops. Ok, vamos a preguntarle a René, le vamos a preguntar a Marta y le vamos a preguntar a Jessica, ¿ok? Ok, sería René, aquí sería Marta, ¿ok? Y aquí nos contestará Jessica. Okay, here we go. How often do you have meetings, René?
Okay, I have meetings once a week.
Okay, once a week. Excellent. Oops, sorry. Okay, now what about Marta?
I have meetings once a month.
Okay. Okay, once a month. Mm-hmm. Jessica, what about you?
I have meetings daily.
Okay. Daily, good. So let's see. Vamos a cambiar esta última dinámica y vamos a ver. Yo voy a decir un nombre y le hace la pregunta a cualquiera de ellos tres, ¿ok? Luego, al que usted le pregunta al siguiente y así sucesivamente, ¿ok? ¿Se comprende? Ok, Julio, please ask René about number two. Question number two. Well, you can choose who you want to ask.
I'm sorry, teacher.
Usted puede escoger al que usted le quiera preguntar de ellos tres, René, Marta y Jessica, ¿ok? It's question number two.
Jessica, how often do you use the microwave?
Use the microwave twice a month.
Okay. Twice a month. Okay.
Yes.
Now let's see. Jessica, please choose one of your classmates, René or Marta, and ask the question.
Okay. Marta, how often do you use the microwave?
I use the microwave every day for lunch.
Excellent. Okay, Marta, please ask. Ask René number René. Two.
Mm-hmm. How often do you use the microwave?
Well, Marta, I use the microwave weekly.
Okay. Thank you very much, guys. Okay. Now, ahora vamos a cambiar la dinámica y le vamos a preguntar, perdón, yo voy a decir un nombre y usted escoge a cualquiera de sus compañeros y le hace la pregunta número tres. Y así, el que sigue igual, número tres. El que sigue, número tres, hasta completar estos tres espacios, ¿ok? Vamos a ver. Kalek.
Sí.
Escoja un compañero.
Escojo.
Ajá.
Ok. Levin.
Okay.
Okay.
Usted le hace la pregunta número tres. You ask question number three.
Who?
Kalek.
How often? Leave work late.
Do you, le faltó. How often do you?
Do you leave work late?
Excellent. Uh-huh. Okay, Levin.
I usually work late, Kalek, Miss Kalek.
Okay. Usually, vamos a ponerlo así. Okay. Thank you. Now, Levin, choose one of your classmates.
Okay. I want to see. Is my classmate Kenny Cuellar. How often have business lunches, Kenny?
Y vamos a hacer la misma, pero está bien. Está bueno que se pasó a la otra. Vamos a ver.
Okay. It doesn't matter. I'm gonna make the sentence with the third line.
No, it's okay with number four. Así okay. Terminamos las seis, okay?
How often have business lunches, Kenny?
Otra vez, Levin.
How often have business
Le lunches? Le falta do you.
Okay. How often do you have business lunches, Kenny?
I hardly ever have business lunches.
Okay. There we go. Now, you choose another one, okay? Another.
I was nervous, teacher.
Why?
I don't know.
Oh, come on. Okay, continue, please. ¿Con quién me quedé?
Kenny.
Kenny. Okay, Kenny, go ahead, please. You choose a classmate and ask the question number five.
It is Jenny.
Okay.
The number four or?
Yes, number five.
Okay. It is, how often do you have training?
I have training. Never.
Okay, estructuremos lo que va en la oración. I
never have time.
Excellent. Thank you very much. It is Janet. So let's continue with it is. Please choose another classmate and ask question number six.
Number six. Okay. Veamos a Estela.
Okay.
Tell me.
Estela, how often go out with you to work?
Co-workers.
Mm-hmm. Otra vez. Perdón. Again.
How often go out with you to work?
It is remember, do you?
Exactly.
Do you?
Aquí está cómo empieza la pregunta. Mire, how often do you?
Okay.
Y aquí la termina.
Okay. How often do you go up with your working?
I have never go out with my coworkers.
Hardly ever. Okay, Estela. Let's see. Hardly ever. Right here, Estela. Okay, Estela hardly ever goes out, right? Excellent. Esta palabra, usted diga siempre, mire, Iris, o todos. Abran bien la boca y digan out, como esta OU sería una AU, right?
Out.
Yes. Bien, ¿queda claro hasta aquí donde estamos con lo de los frequency adverbs?
Missing one sentence, teacher.
Which one?
Celebrate employees' birthday parties.
Oh, yes, but we don't have any more space here. But it's okay. We can just say it. Mm-hmm. Can you ask the question, Levin?
How often do you celebrate employees' birthday parties?
Choose who? Who is going to answer?
Are you?
To me. Okay.
Yeah.
We never celebrate employees' birthday parties in my job. We never. Yeah, it's because of the pandemic, because we are working from, we are doing home office, right? So that is why.
You can do meeting in the office.
Yeah, like virtual, right? Like virtual. But we're not doing that at the moment. We're not doing that. We used to do it, but we don't anymore.
I'm going to give you a balloon when it's your birthday.
Well, sorry, you missed mine. Mine was the 29th of October, right? October the 29th. So no. Yeah, it's not.
It doesn't matter. And the last October.
Okay, next October. Yeah, next. Okay, guys. Thank you very much, Levin, for that virtual gift you gave me. Okay, now, vamos a pasar entonces al nuevo tema, okay? El nuevo tema es imperatives. Y decíamos que los imperatives, vamos a entrar de lleno acá. Okay, we use imperatives giving commands, giving instructions, for advice, or prohibitions, okay? When do we use imperatives? When giving commands, when giving instructions, for advice or provisions. Aquí tenemos algunos ejemplos, mira. Aquí tenemos una lista de ejemplos cómo sería un imperativo. Un imperativo es una orden, ¿ok? Un imperativo es una orden. Y estas oraciones imperativas no llevan un sujeto. Miren cómo está, ¿verdad que no hay un sujeto ahí?
No.
Pero se entiende que el que va a realizar la acción es el que está recibiendo la orden, ¿ok? Usually is you, ¿ok? Usually
it's like is they. Is like an appointment.
Nope.
No.
No. No. Imperatives es para cuando usted da órdenes. Okay?
Like
para
a suggest.
Podría sugerir, pero no. Estas son órdenes directas. Okay? Direct orders.
Okay.
Direct orders. In this case, we are not asking if you can do it or if you can't. You just say that you have to do something, right? You ask
for... You're gonna do and do.
Yes, kind of.
Okay.
Porque puede ser una instrucción, puede ser un consejo o puede ser una prohibición. ¿Qué quiere decir esto? Que no solamente hay afirmativas, ¿verdad? Las oraciones imperativas también hay negativas. Pero en este momento lo que quiero que vean es la estructura de una oración imperativa. Lleva un verbo, miren. A ver, díganme qué verbos miran en esta columna.
Un verbo y un adjetivo.
Not exactly, Levin. A ver, díganme todos los verbos que miran en esta columna de acciones.
Speak.
Okay, these are verbs. Y si se fijan, es un infinitivo, ¿verdad? Pero no lleva la partícula to al principio, sino que es, lo conocemos como un bare infinitive. Bare infinitive, lo vamos a decir aunque quede en un video público, es como un infinitivo chulón. O sea, un infinitivo que no tiene to, ¿ok? Solamente la forma base, pero es un infinitivo, ¿ok? Entonces, vamos a ver. Veamos la primera orden que tenemos acá. Eat healthy. Eat healthy. Lo podríamos considerar también como un consejo, ¿verdad? Podría ser alguna persona que se cuida diciéndole a otra, o podría ser el doctor, ¿verdad? Que usted tiene high blood pressure, tiene presión alta, por ejemplo. Usted fue a donde el doctor y el doctor le dice, eat healthy.
For example, vegetable, like without salt, without grease.
Correct. Mm-hmm. Ahora, veamos la siguiente. Be on time. Be on time.
In your work?
Correct. You should be on time in your work. Correct. But the order is be on time. I'll be there, but you have to be on time, right? Stay safe. De esta para acá, digamos, hasta distance, ¿verdad? Hasta esta. Estamos hablando de instrucciones ahora con esto de la pandemia, ¿verdad? Vamos a ver. Stay safe. Como quien dice, cuídese, muchacho. Cuídese, ¿verdad? Stay safe. Luego tenemos, use a mask. Use a mask. Ok, ahí tenemos un audio que nos está haciendo interferencia. Chicos, por favor, desactivemos los audios. Ok, y cuando usted quiera participar, lo activa. Thank you very much. Ok, now, ahora, con este use a mask, podríamos cambiar este verbo que está acá, que es lo mejor, porque mask es wear. Wear a mask, okay? Wear a mask, okay? Wear a mask. Usar, este es un usar, pero de prendas, ¿ok? Prendas de vestir, ¿ok? Prendas. For example, wear your uniform, wear your sneakers, wear your safety boots, for example. So wear is a verb that express that you have to put on, okay? Put on a mask, right? Wash your hands. Ahora esto se le anda diciendo constantemente a la gente, ¿verdad? Wash your hands. Now, keep 2 meters distance. Keep 2 meters distance. This is essential, right? Esta, call me, right? Call me. Send emails. Come to my party. Ah, esta ya sería como una invitación, ¿verdad? Esta ya es como una invitación, invitation. Come to my party. Be quiet. Command. Hey, be quiet. Okay. Como bien dice, cállate, right? No, it's be quiet. Pero para que no suene así como ese, cállate, okay, utilizamos esta palabra mágica, this magic word. What is the magic word? Please. Okay. Mm-hmm. Entonces, tell me. Entonces, para que sea así como una orden, pero que se oiga polite, que se oiga amable, okay, yo le diría, be quiet, please. Okay, be quiet, please.
Or can I say, could you be quiet?
Yes, of course.
In the intonation is louder?
Yeah, but if you use, excuse me?
Oh, please. Be quiet.
Correct. You can use please at the end or you can use please at the beginning and it is okay. It doesn't matter the order. You can use please at the end or please at the beginning. Okay. Con respecto de usar el auxiliar, could es una magnífica idea. It's a great idea to use the vocabulary that you already know. Porque could es un verbo auxiliar que nos ayuda a expresar el lenguaje formal amable, okay? El lenguaje formal amable. I can say, could you please call me? Okay? Could you call me please? Y está correcto. Pero no nos vamos a extender a explicar cómo se usa el could ahorita. Ahorita estamos en los imperativos. René, por ahí veo que está escribiendo. Cuénteme, ¿qué quiere escribir? Se me está aburriendo don René que está escribiendo por ahí colochos. Ok, vamos a ver. Entonces, decíamos, speak louder.
Sorry, teacher, just my cell phone doesn't work.
Oh, okay, no problem. Now we have here, speak louder. For example, someone is speaking like this. So, yeah, no, okay, no problem. Speak louder, please. Hey, hábleme más fuerte que no le oigo, right? Speak louder, please. Okay, hasta este momento, en esta columna que estamos viendo, este grupo de oraciones se llaman oraciones imperativas, ¿ok? Imperative sentences. ¿Qué es lo peculiar de esto? Que no lleva un sujeto, ¿verdad? No lleva un sujeto. Directamente el verbo y la acción, ¿right? El verbo y el complemento de la acción. Ok. Vamos a ir entonces en nuestro manual to the next page. I think it is 22, right? 22, I think it is. And we have this conversation. It's between Marcia and Luke. I just want to ask you something, guys. How often do you give orders in your workplaces? How often do you give orders in your workplaces?
I never give orders in my workplace or work because I have a boss and okay. he give me orders.
Okay.
I receive orders.
Okay.
Yeah, of course.
Okay. Okay. Perfect. That's good. That's good. And how often do you receive those commands?
Always.
Uh-huh. Always. Okay, yeah. Great. I always receive these commands.
Okay.
Hay un detalle, miren. Commands es como una orden, pero no como una orden. Sí, puede ser como una orden de trabajo, pero order, like this, esa palabra, order, right? And command son instrucciones que se le dan, por ejemplo, stand up. For example, you say, sit down. No es necesariamente una orden, sino que le pide a alguien que haga algo. ¿Ok? Eso es un command. ¿Perdón?
Close it in the window.
Yes, close the window. Correct. Close the window. It's a command. Correct. Veamos entonces en esta conversación cómo usan esos commands. Okay, veamos. Marcia, I'm going to read the conversation and then we're going to figure these out. Okay, so please send this package. Yes, ma'am. Do you need anything else? Actually, yes. Please write a memo about the new date for the general meeting right away. Give me one of those memo stickers, please. Sure, here you go. Oh, and look, please supervise the new interns. Absolutely. If you see here, we have commands, we have orders, and also we have some reactions, okay? We have some reactions. Vamos a ver cuáles son las reacciones en palabras cuando recibimos un command o cuando recibimos una orden o un consejo o una prohibición, por ejemplo, usando cuando alguien nos hace una nos da un command, ¿verdad? Entonces, veamos. Please send this package. Yes, ma'am. Do you need anything else? Actually, yes. Please write a memo about the new date for the general meeting. Right away, give me one of those memo stickers, please. Sure, here you go. Oh, and Luke, please supervise the new interns. Absolutely. Okay. Do you have any question about the vocabulary in this conversation?
Package is like a backpack.
Anything else?
Okay, package. Did you say package? Like yeah. This? Okay. Yes, es un paquete. Package. Yes. It could be a box. It could be a bag. Whatever. It's a package. Something that you have to send to another country, to another office, or just to deliver. Right. A package. Okay, and anything else? Anything else that
what is the meaning with right away?
Ahí vamos. Right away, lo que es una reacción. Solo quiero contestar que es anything else.
Okay.
Anything else significa alguna otra cosa más. Okay. Do you need anything else?
Nothing else. Okay.
Okay, ahora, estaba hablando yo de las reacciones, the reactions, cuando recibimos una orden o un command. Veamos aquí los commands y veamos la reacción. For example, please write a memo about the new date for the general meeting. ¿Y cuál es la reacción?
Right away.
Right away.
Como que le dijéramos, va pues ahorita, ¿verdad? Right away. Okay. Me pidieron que yo escriba el memo acerca de la nueva fecha, ¿verdad? De la reunión general. Entonces, yo, va, pues está bien, correcto, no hay problema, ahorita se lo hago, ¿verdad? Entonces, eso es right away. Right away. Right in this moment. Oh,
teacher, sorry.
Mm-hmm.
I have a question.
Tell me.
What's the difference in something else or anything else? What's the difference?
Okay, the difference is that here any is used with negative and questions, usually, okay? Usually. For affirmative, we use something else, okay? I need something else, for example. I don't need anything else. Si se fija, afirmativo, something else. Negative, I don't need anything else. Ahora, en pregunta, do you need, decimos anything, no decimos something else, okay? Do you need anything else? Correct?
Thank you so much. Thank you
there
so
you
much.
Go. There you go. So now, guys, we are going to practice this conversation. We have to role play this conversation. Two volunteers. I see someone is raising his hand. Okay, Levin, go ahead. You are the first one. And Iris Marina is the next volunteer. Thank you, Iris, for volunteering. Okay, there you go. Go ahead. Okay, Iris is Marcia and Levin is Luke.
Okay. Are you ready, Levin?
Yes, of course, Miss Marina Portillo de Reyes.
Okay. Please send Jane Page.
This package.
Okay. Please.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Sorry.
Yes.
Ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Do you need anything else?
Actuality, yes. Please write a memo, a book.
Actually.
Wait, Levin.
Okay, actually, yes. Please write a memo, a book.
About
the new date for the January meeting.
Excellent. Actually significa in fact, okay? De hecho, no significa actualmente, chicos. Aquí significa actually, in fact. Ok, de hecho sí, le dice. ¿Necesitas algo más? De hecho sí. All right. Actually, yes. There okay. You go. Continue.
Right away, give me one of those memos. Remove this.
I did it. Go ahead.
Ok, right away, give me one of those memo stickers, please.
Sure. Here you go. Oh, and look, please, supervisor, the net interest.
The new interest.
Absolutely.
Excellent. So now, guys, here you see another reaction. Miren, esta es otra reacción en palabras. Claro que en hecho, la reacción es hacer la actividad que le están pidiendo. Pero en palabras, ¿qué le decimos a la persona que nos está dando una orden o un command? Ah, entonces, por ejemplo, aquí Luke le dice, give me one of those memo stickers, please. La reacción es, sure.
Seguro.
Here you go. Así vos toma, aquí está, right? Something like this, right? Here you go significa aquí tienes, okay? Aquí tienes o... Va, ahí te va, right? Something like this. Yeah, ya ese ya es usando más mi florido folclore, ¿verdad?
Okay, thank you.
Okay, I see someone, okay, René, go ahead, please.
Yes, I'm here. Okay, I have a question.
Tell me.
What's the difference between here you go and here you are?
And there is another one, here you have, okay?
Sure.
So, yes.
I forget, but...
No problem, but okay. Yes. This is depending on the context, like this one, right? Here you go is like, ahí te va, right? Something, it's it's going from here to there, right? But if I give it in hand, okay, here you are, right? Here you are, or here you have, okay? It's kind of closer than go, right? That could be, eso es haciéndolo un poquito la diferencia, pero en realidad depende del contexto. It depends on the context.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I understand. Thank you so much.
Okay, no problem. Guys, it's 9:41 now, okay? We are going to complete this figure out and then teníamos otro acá. Perdón. Solo déjenme llegar a la otra página. Bueno, okay. Terminemos este de figure it out. Okay. Este es como adivinémoslo, right? Complete the following commands. Use the conversation above as reference, as a reference. So now, what do you think is the imperative sentence here? Number one.
Right.
Please what?
Mm-hmm. Good. Mm-hmm. One second. Here we go. Please write. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay. A ver, leámosla. ¿Cómo dice esa oración?
Please write a memo about
Actually, yes. Please write a memo about the new day for the general meeting.
Okay. ¿Y cómo sonaría si le, pusiéramos write a memo about the new date, please? ¿Cómo suena?
It's more, that is more polite.
No es que sea más o menos polite, okay? En pesado. Este caso, ¿perdón?
Pesado.
¿Lo siente como pesado?
It doesn't sound like a comments.
Like a command?
Commands.
Okay.
It sounds like an order.
Like asking for a favor, right? Like asking for a favor. If I say, write a memo about the new date, I'm sorry, about the new date, please. It's like a favor, right? See? Pero si le digo yo, please write a memo about the new date, it sounds more like a command, right? Is it?
Different.
Do you think it is indifferent?
Yeah.
It could be. It could be. And it depends, again, on the context. But yes, it's okay. So number two. Number two.
Give one of those stickers.
Okay.
That is a favor.
Aha, uh-huh. So you noticed. Uh-huh.
That is a favor because he telling him those memo sticker, please.
Yes, correct. Correct. Okay. Entonces, sí tiene un poquito que ver en el contexto si lo digo al principio o al final. En el momento que usted, en este caso, es una gran actividad. Miren lo que le está pidiendo, ¿verdad? Pero en las normales, en una command, en un simple command, no importa si va al principio o va al final. Dependerá en el contexto si es, se siente como que le está pidiendo un favor o como que está pidiendo, haciendo una orden. Por ejemplo, en este caso, ¿quién será el jefe? Who is the boss?
Maybe it's Marcia.
Maybe, yeah. Right? Why?
Because she said the...
She's sending the package.
Okay, but in the context, in the meaning of the sentences that she's...
She gives the commands and then
La mayor look, parte de
la... Look is receiving the command because the Marcia is ordered to look.
Uh-huh. Exactly. Esta palabra, ma'am, que dice acá, nos da mucha luz también en eso, porque ma'am es como...
Like a mom.
No, not no. Mom.
Madame.
Not mom. Y tenemos que pronunciar, exactly, madame. Viene de madame, pero es una forma de responder en el femenino, ¿verdad? De decirle yes, sir, si fuera un hombre, ¿ok? Yes, sir, el femenino es yes, ma'am, sí, señora, ¿ok? Like, yes, ma'am. No digamos yes, ma'am, porque entonces ya le dijimos sí, mamá, right? Entonces tenemos que pronunciarlo correctamente, like ma'am, okay? Ma'am, ma'am, like kind of long. To understand this, yes, ma'am, okay, es como decir sí, señora, en el femenino cuando decimos sí, señor, right? Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, ma'am.
Romeo Santos said that word.
Okay, well, yes, ma'am. Okay, I don't know about Romeo Santos, but now about yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, teacher.
No, I'm sorry. I don't know about him. I don't know him. Okay, este ma'am lo que les está indicando es que le está hablando con mucho respeto. Yeah, le está hablando con respeto. Yeah, le está hablando y le está diciendo, le está reconociendo que, pues, ella es la que da las órdenes, right? She's the one giving the orders. So now, let's see. Number three.
I think teacher Marcia, like, it's a boss's look.
That's what you think?
Yeah. Marcia, another way. Marcia is a boss. No, Marcia is Luke's boss.
Okay, yes, Marcia is Luke's boss. Yes.
Luke's boss, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. I think that because she is ordering.
She's ordering. Yeah, she's giving the commands. Okay, now let's see number three. Number three. Let's complete this command.
Please supervise.
Okay, good. So it is, please supervise. Mm-hmm. They new interns, right? They new interns. Oops. Okay, please supervise the new interns. Do you have any question about this topic at the moment? We're going to continue, but is there any question about this conversation and the vocabulary?
I'm a little confused with this topic, teacher.
I'm
understand, but I'm thinking a lot when I wanna use the command. And in favor, the different kind is a little complete for me.
Okay, no se complique, no se complique. Le vamos a decir así, pero esto entre nosotros, ¿verdad? No le van a decir a todos, le van a decir, don't suffocate and don't a whole lot, right?
Don't. La milena okay. Mayor, don a whole lot.
Okay. Don't suffocate and don't a whole lot. No, this is just joking, guys. This is just joking. Entonces, solo para que no se complique un poco, okay, fijémonos que cualquier command, cualquier orden es una oración imperativa. En el contexto, cuando usted quiera pedir un favor, usted va a decir please, ¿verdad? Y usualmente nosotros los salvadoreños decimos por favor, por favorcito, right? O sea, somos muy así para pedir las cosas hasta que le doblamos el brazo al otro, pero de una manera así como, ay, es que para que no se sienta mal le voy a pedir este favor. Pero tratamos de hacerlo así. In English, we're not like that. El idioma inglés es directo. Okay. El idioma inglés no anda con tanta vuelta ni con rodeo, va directo, patada al pecho. ¿Verdad? Entonces, no se complique en que si es favor o si es command. Command es command. Command es command. Solo estábamos tratando de analizar un poquito, ir un poquito más allá. Pero okay. En realidad, command es command.
Es command, Iris. That's it.
Dígame, Iris.
De repente en una reunión o con algunos amigos, así, se está pasando un momento de broma y entre todos, y sale la palabra, ¡eh, come on! Ajá. ¿Es lo mismo? ¿El mismo come on de ahorita?
No.
Yes and no. Ok, sí es la, el mismo verbo, pero en ese caso es un significado como... Ey, hombre, calmate, ey, bájale, ey, no, hombre, vos, ok, es, ey, come on, yeah, something like this.
Bien, gracias.
Ok, ok. Perdón, solo le termino de contestar con Iris. Come on, si yo le digo a alguien como una orden, como un command, come on, ah, lo estoy llamando que venga, ok. Pero cuando yo digo, come on, it's not the same meaning. Pero sí es el mismo, la misma escritura y el mismo verbo, come on. Okay, there you go, Kenny. Tell me. Tell me, Kenny.
Sure. Como los imperatives son, digamos, como ya definidos fijos. No importa a qué persona o grupo de personas se lo dirijamos, el verbo siempre se mantiene igual.
Exactly. Yes. Yes. Because in the negative way, ahí podríamos comprender un poquito esto. In the negative way, no utilizamos doesn't, solo utilizamos don't. ¿Han visto ustedes prohibiciones o órdenes como don't smoke? Okay. O miran, don't write, en este caso, ¿verdad? Please write, don't write a memo, ok, don't write a memo. No le estoy diciendo, you don't, queda como implícito, ¿verdad? Queda como implícito y solo es don't. No se usa, no cambia, no cambia a terceras personas ni nada de eso. Mm-mm. Es lo mismo, el verbo. Ok. Ok, guys. We have 2 more minutes before taking the attendance. Just let me go to the manual. In the manual we have, in the handbook, well, it's not handbook now because it's virtual. We have a reading and an explanation of the concept of commands. Okay, so let's go and read it. I will share this page for you.
I didn't feel the time, teacher.
Didn't you?
Missing 6 minutes.
Y en los anteriores sí lo ha sentido. Oh. Okay, there we go. There we go. No, es que hoy ya les agarré a ustedes el nivel en que vamos. Ya vamos como sobre ruedas, ¿verdad? Ya hoy sí sienten, ya esta clase fue como más sobre ruedas. ¿Sí o no?
Sí, es que sí.
¿Cómo sienten? ¿Los demás vamos a escuchar? ¿Vamos bien? Y todos así como, sí, DJ. Okay. Thank you very much, Iris. Now, Estela, please, can you read the concept of command?
Okay, thank you. Mm-hmm. Commands are direct instructions or orders to do something.
Thank you very much. What are commands, guys?
That those are direct instructions.
Instructions, uh-huh.
Instruction or orders to do something.
Thank you very much. Marielos, what are the commands?
Comprendí.
What are the commands? ¿Qué son los comandos? Aquí leamos. Mire, Marielos.
Okay. Uh-huh. Okay. Use please.
Aquí en commands are.
Commands are direct instruction or order to do something.
Thank you. To do something. Something. Okay.
Something.
Something. Esto quiere decir que son instrucciones directas o órdenes para hacer algo, ¿verdad? Órdenes a hacer algo. Okay, now, please, Julio, read the next box about the word please plus the command.
Use please. El más, no recuerdo cómo
plus,
se pronuncia.
Plus.
Use please plus the command to sound more polite.
Polite.
Polite, e.g. Please place an order for more boxes. Call the supervisor, please.
Thank you. Bueno, vamos a explicar esta que está aquí, ¿verdad? Esta, aunque la veamos como E-G, la vamos a leer como for example, ¿ok? For example. Esta viene del latín, ¿ok? Como like et gratia or something like this, como por decir... como una demostración, ¿verdad? Entonces lo leemos for example, ¿ok? Yes, for example. So I'm going to read it again. Thank you, Julio, for reading. I'm going to read it from here. To sound more polite, for example, right? Please place an order for more boxes. That's one sentence. Next one. Call the supervisor, please. Okay, if you see, we have please at the beginning, please at the end, and you sound more polite. Suena más formal, más amable, ¿verdad? If we use please. Okay, now well, it's 9:58, it's 9:58. But let's read this. How to use commands to order or tell someone to do something, okay? Veamos acá. These are examples in our jobs, okay? In our jobs. Please write a check. Please send a memo. Please check the report. Please supervise the employees. Go to a meeting, please, okay? Or please go to a meeting. Okay, now guys, I just want to show you, no, it's 9:59, so it's time for taking the attendance. Mañana yo les voy a mostrar ejemplos de la forma negativa de las oraciones imperativas y vamos a hacer también algunos ejercicios, okay? Bien, just let me call the roll. Oh my God. Okay, there we go. Amanda Graciela Pérez Orellana.
Present teacher.
Caleca Visaí Marinero Asensio.
Present teacher.
Candelaria de Los Ángeles Nolasco de Flores.
Present.
Carol Ibe Chávez Reyes.
Present.
Cristian Edenilson Ayala Ramírez.
Present teacher.
Okay. Delmi Guadalupe Martínez Marroquín.
Present.
Delmi. Yes, you said present. Okay. Edwin Joel Amaya Palacios. Estela Mabel Orellana de Del Cid.
Present teacher.
Iliana Carolina Calderón Cisneros.
Present teacher.
Okay. Iris Marina Portillo de Reyes.
Present.
Okay. Iris Janet Barrera Herrera.
Present teacher.
Julio César Ramírez Arevalo.
Present.
Karen Marisela Rivera de Martínez.
Present teacher.
Carla Raquel Mendoza Hernández. Carla Raquel, are you there? Kenny Lizette Cuellar de Barrientos. Yo vi que pusieron un mensaje, pero creo que sí, fue sure. Carla, ¿verdad? Kenny Lizette, right?
Present.
Okay, thank you. Levin Giovanni Martinez.
Present teacher.
Okay. Marta Lidia Godinez.
Present teacher.
Okay. Okay, Marta Lidia. Let's see. One second. René Armando Avendaño Pineda.
Present teacher.
Thank you. Reinaldo Chavez Guerra. Mr. Reinaldo, are you there? Okay, I knew it, I knew it. Okay. Alexandra Raquel Ávila de Axume.
Present teacher.
Okay, Ingrid Yamilet Erazo Aranda. Jessica del Carmen Vázquez Vázquez.
Present.
Carla Yanet García González.
Present.
María Magdalena Ronquillo Magaña.
Present.
Marielos Janet Cornejo Erazo.
Present teacher.
Okay. Vilma Consuelo Guzmán de Girón.
Present.
There we are, guys. So we are off the clock now. It's 2 minutes past 10. So no me queda más que decirles y pedirles con firmeza que por favor hagan la tarea y vayan al tiempo, que vayan on time con las tareas para que no se les acumulen el día viernes y la teacher no los ande persiguiendo, ¿verdad? Entonces, por favor, hacer la tarea todos. Si tienen alguna pregunta, por favor, no duden y manden su pregunta en el grupo de WhatsApp. Con gusto les vamos a contestar, ¿ok? Les vamos, suena a muchos, ¿vale? Les voy a contestar. Bien, vamos a ver entonces. Nos quedamos con Karen, no, con René, ¿ok?
Have a good night, teacher.
Okay, then, see have a good rest and let us meet tomorrow.
Good night. Good night.
Thank you very much. Have a good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Bye.
Good night. Bye, Reinaldo.
Thank you, teacher. Good night.
Okay, have a good night, Kenny. Bye.
Hi, teacher.
Okay, Delmi, le reviso nuevamente. Okay, yo me comunico. One moment, please, René, because we have to be just you and me here, okay? There
of course.
We go. Okay.
I'm waiting for you.
Okay, no problem. Here we go. No, not yet. Hello, Lisette.
I think she is sleeping.
Do you think so?
I think so. I don't know.
She was participating. She was participating. Lisette? Okay, I will do this. Okay.
I said you.
Okay.
Okay.
Here we are, René. How can I help you? Do you have any question about the topics or something?
About the topic.
Or the topics?
I don't think so. I feel so comfortable with the topic. For me, it's easy topic, you know, because I was learning English and in another time, it's like maybe 6 months ago. And okay. Right now I feel so good with this topic. It's just like a beginner for me, and I'm beginner too, but not so beginner, you know? I'm as like a medium.
Yes, I see you have enough vocabulary for this level. Yeah.
Of course I have, because
yeah.
Because maybe it's for practice, because I practice every day and I study every day, and I feel
okay.
I feel so good, and I don't have any question at all.
Okay.
But
okay.
If you want, how many times we have right now, or how many?
Okay, ahí sería how much time do we have?
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
How much?
You have 10 minutes. Have? 10 minutes.
Oh,
of 10 fame.
Minutes. Of course, yeah. I want to talk with you about.
Okay, talk to me. No problem. Let's talk.
Of course. I love to talk in English, and
great.
If I have my teacher here, it's better.
Okay,
you know?
Good. Yeah. I'll do my best with you. Okay.
Okay, perfect. And okay.
I see sometimes you're working. How do you battle with this? How do you what's the equilibrium in this with your classes and the work?
Okay, right now I work sometimes at night, but it's always when it's very necessary, because I have permission for my work, because I work in a bar, you know, in a bar, but I was talking with my boss, and I said I need to learn a lot of English, because I work in a bar, but this bar is it's from a hotel, you know.
Okay.
It's not public bar, just guests.
International, right?
International,
mm-hmm.
of course.
Mm-hmm.
And I was talking about it with my boss, and I said I want to learn a lot English, because here is very important. And he said, sure, of course, but when it's necessary, you just, I will need your help. And I said, of course. And
okay.
For that, sometimes I work in my class, you know, but it's not always, because I have permission for that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but right now I'm in another course, but this is presential, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Presential is okay?
It is okay.
Okay, yeah, and I have permission too. I have a lot of permission, because every day in my schedule is like one day you start at 6 a.m. to 2 p.m. In the another day, it's 2 p.m. to 10 p.m. But in my case, it's different, because I'm learning English, you know?
Okay.
And my schedule is like, I started around 10 a.m. and
uh-huh.
I finish around 7.
Oh,
or
okay.
I start around 6 a.m. and I finish 2 p.m., you know?
Okay.
But
because
I have two courses right now.
Okay.
And for me, it's so important, the English, and I want to learn a lot. This is for me. And I love the English.
Okay.
It's so nice. Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. When you said in another day, you have to say, you said the another day, like this, right?
Oh, the,
you say
the another
the,
day.
Uh-huh, that's not correct. Okay. You should say the other day, or
the other day.
Yes. Or just another day.
The other day.
Mm-hmm.
The other day or another day. No.
Not another day. Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Okay.
Thank you. Okay.
Yeah.
This is, oh, perfect.
Okay. You could say the other day, but the other day means different than another day. Another
Why?
Day, because the other day is like in the past, right? Like in the
other.
Past. The other day,
okay.
I was doing this and this and that. But if you say another, this day and another day, I do this, right? Like you
okay.
change the activity from one day to another day, right?
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Then in this case is another day, right?
Yes. Yes.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
That's the correct word for the phrase you said. You were talking about the classes and your activities, right? So yes,
sure.
You say another day. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay. And when
perfect.
You say I love, you don't say the English, okay?
Yeah.
I'm sorry. You say, I love English, okay?
I love English.
Yes, without the English, okay?
Oh.
Because
perfect.
In Spanish, we usually say, me encanta el inglés, right? But in English, we don't say that. We just say, I love English, right?
I love English. Mm-hmm. Okay, this is, I have a lot of mistakes.
Yeah, but it's not like, I mean, you are not going to be punished for that. Everybody is going to understand. Don't worry. These are not these are not content mistakes, right? This is these are just grammarly, I mean, grammatically mistakes, grammar mistakes.
Sure.
But it doesn't change the meaning. Okay, it doesn't change the meaning. But this one, yes. But this one, no. Okay, esta sí le cambia el significado, but this one doesn't change the meaning.
Okay, perfect. I need to work in this
yeah, area, some details. You know, in this These topic. Are some details. Details, right? Details. Detalles, details. Yeah. Rene, are you there? Are you still there? Rene, don't leave me. Rene.